Yeah, every Tuesday and Thursday around this time, we like to bring you one of our classic second date updates that you likely missed the first time around, especially if you don't normally have a chance to listen to us at a later hour. Christine is looking for a second date update with a guy named Frank. Hey, Christine.
Hi there.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Hanging in there.
Good.
Welcome to the show. You want to fill us in on Frank? Tell us how you met and all that good stuff.
Sure, yeah. So we met online on POF, Plenty of Fish, and he just had a nice demeanor about him. He was like a nice guy, which is kind of crazy because that's not my normal type. I don't know. That might sound weird, but I seem to get like the guys who are probably not super nice. But I could just tell, like, wow. Okay, let me just go off and do something different for a change. And he's really outgoing and funny, which once again, that's me kind of taking a stance on something different because I normally like the guys that are quieter because I like to really drive the conversation.
There you go. Yeah, you don't want anybody upstaging you, right?
Exactly.
I get that. So this guy has more of an outgoing personality than what you normally go for then, huh?
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely. Yeah, he's total, you know, extrovert, which is kind of nice for a change because I was able to kind of just, you know, sit back, let him take the wheel, and it kind of felt a little more even keel, too, instead of it being like an imbalanced thing. So I did like that. Well, since everything was going really well, like online, we chatted for a bit, started talking on the phone, and everything was super cash, and we decided to meet for dinner.
So you met for dinner?
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm taking notes. I'm listening. Go ahead.
So we went out. We had a great dinner. Lots of good conversation. It's very meaningful, and I really continue to think like we were on the same page with a lot of things. A lot of things that are really, like, you know, serious for me as far as like politics, marriage, global warming, you know, all
yeah.
those simple things.
Sure.
People love to discuss on the first date.
Right.
And typically I don't do that, but it just went so well that it just really kept flowing, you know?
Right.
So yeah, so anyways, we were at the restaurant for a couple hours and had a few glasses of wine, and I wanted to continue the night, you know.
All
but
right.
He mentioned that he had to get up early because he was going to help his good friend, like, move.
Okay.
So I understood, you know. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying, like, he's super, super nice. So I really like that about him. Well, he did walk me to my car. He gave me a nice hug, super gentleman, kissed me on the cheek, and said to have a good rest of the evening. Mm-hmm. And I haven't heard from him, so I don't know what might have happened.
Not since then. So there's been no communication since the hug and the kiss on the cheek and the bye-bye in the parking lot, huh?
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, which I thought was weird because, you know, we definitely had a good connection.
Yeah. Did he pay for dinner?
Yes. He did.
And
I said, total gent.
And did you send him a text thanking him for dinner? Like a follow-up text thanking him for
yeah,
dinner?
Yeah, I did do that, you know.
And was there not a response to that either?
No, there wasn't. I just didn't know if he got, like, he went to sleep, maybe got busy early in the morning because he wanted to help with his friends. So I understood that. So I kind of let a few days go by, and then the week went by, and I was thinking, oh, I don't know.
You're pretty chill that you kind of tabled it. You weren't over analytical about it from the beginning. Like, oh, he didn't answer me. You kind of cut him some slack, but then a few days go by, and then you're like, hey, wait, whatever happened to this guy?
Yeah.
Well, that's a bummer, because if you had this substantive, I think the word you used was meaningful conversation, and you found yourself on the same page on so many of the big issues that are important to you, just in life and love and politics and everything else, that's the guy you want to meet up with again, you know?
Yeah, when you can just flow like that, especially like on the first date.
I mean,
that's a lot.
All right. Well, are there any other details we need to know before we take a break? Because if you can't think of anything, we'll just go ahead and call him.
Yeah, no, I can't. I really just kind of want to know what's going on.
We can do that. That's what Second Date Update is all about. So you hang tight. I need to put you on hold for just a sec. Fritch will pick up while we're in the break. She'll get the phone number from you. We'll get this whole thing set up, and we'll, if all goes well, talk to Frank, find out what he thought of Christine and his date with her. Coming up next with Jeff and Jen here at Q102. So Christine went out with this guy named Frank, who she met on Plenty of Fish. They talked for a little bit before they finally made a date to meet up for dinner. And the interesting thing about Nick is he's a little bit different than most of the guys Christine has dated in the past. He's a little more outgoing than past boyfriends. In the past, she's always kind of gone for the quieter type. She reminds me of Fritch a little bit. And
yeah.
Because when you're such an outgoing person, you know, you need somebody who is okay with you leading the conversation.
To balance you out and listen to you.
Exactly. So she stepped out of her comfort zone a little bit by going out with Frank, because Frank is also very outgoing. But dinner was great. They had meaningful, that's the word she used, meaningful conversation where they discovered they were on the same page on a lot of the things, a lot of the issues that matter to Christine. And it was a good couple of hours. They were at this restaurant sharing a few glasses of wine before they finally parted ways at the restaurant. She was all set to invite him back to her place, right, Christine?
That's right, definitely.
So he could have if he wanted to, but being the nice guy that he is, he said he had to get up early to help a friend move. So that wasn't going to happen. So they shared a hug and a kiss on the cheek in the parking lot. And then that was it. She has not heard from him since. She did send him a follow-up text saying, hey, that was great, thanks for dinner. But there was no response from him, and there hasn't been. And you weren't even really that stressed about it right away. You just kind of let a few days go by before you were like, hey, where is this guy?
Yeah, I tried to be understanding of the whole situation.
I know, I love how chill you are about all this.
Yeah, well, it's been a week, so I tried to talk myself through it.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I was, but now I kind of want an answer.
And now I'm drinking alone every night.
All right, so let's do this. We're going to go ahead and call Frank. See if we can get some answers from him.
Hello?
Hi, is this Frank?
Yeah, this is Frank.
Hey, Frank. My name is Jeff Thomas, and I'm with the Jeff and Jen Morning Show on Q102. And
Jeff and Jen?
Yes, sir.
Are you serious?
I'm serious. I got my partner Jen. Fritch and Tim are both here.
Hi.
Good morning.
Hi.
No, I don't want to do this.
What?
Oh, no.
What's wrong, Frank?
I really wish I hadn't picked up the phone.
Can I just say, first of all, I'm surprised you're reacting this way, because if we're talking about the same person, she sounds delightful.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, is this about Christine?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Okay.
What's wrong? She got a completely different, if it was that bad, she had a completely different read on the date than you did.
Let me just tell you the deal, okay?
Please.
She is living on a completely different planet. Just some of the things that she talked about, like, she thinks Donald Trump is the greatest president of all time.
Okay. And you don't?
I think that there's maybe a very small percentage of people who do at this point.
Well, the reason I'm asking is because she said you seemed pretty united on most of the big issues, and you talked about everything under the sun, and she walked away with the impression you saw eye to eye on a lot of stuff. So that was one she was wrong about, huh?
That's because there's no talking to people like her.
Oh.
Completely in the clouds and doesn't hear a single thing that you say. She doesn't listen to reason. She'll go on and on and on and on about how she loves the way that he's so honest and real and isn't afraid to speak the truth when that truth is absolute, complete, utter nonsense.
Mm.
And she really loves this guy. Like, the guy who is playing both sides of the Nazi issue right now. Like, come on. Nazis, do you think Nazis are bad, Jeff?
yes, I do think Nazis are bad, Frank.
Yeah, it's a pretty clear answer there. And she refuses to accept that stance that he's playing both sides, and it's just nonsense. So okay. I smiled, I nodded, as polite as possible, and, you know.
Wow, okay. I got to say, Christine, I feel like I called the wrong guy. He sounds so different than the way you describe your experience with him at the restaurant.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I mean, we had all the conversation online first, and when it came to working out, movies, and things like that, then it just kind of continued to go. You know, like I said, the conversation kept going, the connection seemed to kind of get just more in depth, and then it led to what it did on our date for dinner, and it all seemed very natural.
Hmm. And Frank, do you agree with that take? Like, outside of politics, did you seem like you connected on a lot of other stuff?
I don't know. It's tough to say, because when you're starting to get to know someone, obviously you want it to work out, and you want it to go well.
Right.
So you present your best self, and you're pretty agreeable, but you know, once we started getting on things that really matter, it was just like, oh my God, this person is a complete phony and a total monster. I mean, ask her about the global warming.
Oh, I don't even want to get into that here.
No, you don't. Yeah.
Let's not. It's climate change. It's not global warming. Climate change.
No,
we have a new name for
exist.
It.
Okay.
It doesn't exist. That's the problem.
Okay. Well,
so fascinating. Very reflective of the world.
Right, at least we know. So
right
no
now.
Second date. I was just, at this point, I was just trying to analyze how two people can walk away from the same day with completely different impressions of how it went.
Yeah.
Well, there are people who are in touch with the reality and people who aren't.
Oh, wow.
Okay, I better end this now. Frank, you were a good guy for taking the call and indulging
Thanks,
us.
Frank,
I know you didn't
want
to talk
honesty.
To us, but we appreciate you giving us hanging in there long enough to give us an answer.
All right. Thanks.
All right, buddy. Take it easy.
You too.
And Christine, now we know.
Yeah, that just blew my mind. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, for a man to be so passionate about it and still be able to just sit there and nod and act as if he's in agreement.
I know, that's why I'm like, how does he not say anything at the date? I don't understand that.
And he gave her a hug and a kiss on the cheek, too.
I bet he's had situations where he has engaged and it didn't go well.
Yeah. Just biting his lip.
Sometimes it's best to just not say anything.
And not call back.
Nod your head and smile.
Yeah. At the beginning of the date, he definitely seemed more engaged, but by the end, he did get a little quieter, and I just thought he was getting tired. But hindsight, once we started to hit the politics,
right,
he did just start becoming more quiet and just nodded, and I guess I get it now.
Now you know. All right. Well, I'm sorry we couldn't come up with a better outcome for you, Christine, but we appreciate you you calling in, and if we can ever assist again, we're going to try to help you make dating great again. I don't know.
Stop it.
Hey, we can cheers to our 401k numbers.
I'm trying to connect to her.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
Good luck. Take it easy.
Okay. If you've been out on a first date and haven't heard back, you want to know what's up, 513-749-2320 or email Jeff and Jen at WKRQ.com.
Oh, that coffee is extra good this morning.
Yeah? It's hitting a good spot.
Really is.
Good.
All right. What are you in the mood for next? A little news that didn't make the news?
Sure, why not?
You know, work really is way more stressful this time of year. Boy, was I having a red light day today. Mm-hmm. Hit every red light coming in. Yeah, it's raining like crazy. Drive-through line was not only extra long, it's extra slow.
Well, and Merle is not doing well with the time change. I'm trying to explain to him that we have moved the clocks back.
It's an hour.
And yes, he doesn't need to be. Oh, my God. He doesn't need to be pouncing on my face an hour earlier in the morning.
At 4:30?
He is doing it just a little too early.
Push him off.
It's like, Merle.
I don't know. I actually talked about this yesterday on Mom Chat Monday because I don't, my daughter's schedule is all whack-a-doodle-doo now. I mean, everything is off from this 1 hour.
Is it an hour off, or is it just, has she just gone crazy?
Well, but that whole hour has messed things up. So she went to bed at, say, 7 o'clock on Sunday, which is kind of her normal bedtime.
Oh.
But she was really cranky. But in her internal clock thinks it's 8, but she's up at 4:30, then she's down for a nap at 6 a.m., which all of these are off. They're all off by like an hour and an hour and a half now,
when
which
she
has
does,
made our whole schedule wreck.
When she does go down, how long is she, like, how long is, will she sleep for now?
Oh, she'll sleep through the night, but not consistently. For example, last night, people on my Mom Chat Monday were recommending, they said, what you have to do is just keep her up an extra hour and then start reducing that by like 10 minutes or 15 minutes a night to kind of help transition her internal clock.
Mm.
So last night we did that. We kept her up until 8 o'clock.
How'd that go?
And she slept great. She slept through till the morning. But I also think that that's because she was so tired from the night before.
Yeah, done worn her out.
So I don't know.
You
it's
know, if you could only talk reason with babies and dogs,
yes.
we
yes.
would
Cats.
Be in great shape.
Yeah. It's weird because, you know, Scott, who is her father, was like, they don't know what their internal clock is telling them. They're six months old. I'm like, listen to me. She does.
Sure she does.
They really
she
do.
She knows when she's hungry.
Yeah. And that's all messed up now, too. Like, she used to eat at 6, and now she's eating at 5, and she's cranky the whole time until she gets to eat. So the whole this daylight savings thing's never really been that big of a deal until now.
Right. I know. It's been awesome.
Yeah.
Hasn't it been awesome? Remember the day where really did mean an extra hour of sleep?
Or at the bar? Like,
right.
Yeah, the
exactly.
Bar.
I'm with you. Just pick one and be done with it.
Yeah.
Well, pick the one Switching where it's light outside while we're awake.
Yes, and that's
we
the other
that
thing.
One?
Ever since we
changed. I love it when it's light outside at 10 o'clock
it's
at night. That's awesome. Yes.
No, not that, but ever since we've changed, it's nothing but rain and be gross.
Yep.
It's like we asked for that.
Thanks for listening to the Q102 Jeff and Jen Morning Show Podcast, brought to you by CBG Airport. Start your trip at cbgairport.com.
Now it's the president's turn. I'm Rita Foley with an AP News Minute. The government shut down overnight, but lawmakers have now passed a spending bill that would reopen it and send it to the president, who's promised to sign it. AP correspondent Sagar Magani.
Senate leaders had said they had a bipartisan budget compromise, but Kentucky Republican Rand Paul went rogue.
I want people to feel uncomfortable.
Holding up a vote last night over what he called GOP willingness to bust the budget.
We're talking about $1 trillion deficit.
Regular order.
We really ought to have a little more discussion about $1 trillion deficit. I object.
Republican leaders were clearly annoyed, with Majority Whip John Cornyn saying Paul was wasting everybody's time.
It will not accomplish anything.
The Senate ended up easily passing the bill, and the House voted before dawn to end the 5.5-hour shutdown. Sagar Magani at the White House.
The White House says the president will sign the bill into law this morning. I'm Rita.